words, English words, are full of echoes, memories, associations, naturally. They've been out and about, on people's lips, in their houses, in the streets, in the fields, for so many centuries. And that is one of the chief difficulties in writing in today. They're stored with other meanings, with other memories, and they have contracted so many famous marriages in the past. The splendid word incarnadine, for example, who can use that without remembering multitudinous scenes?